हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू वीडियो लेक्चर सब्जेक्ट कंप्यूटर साइंस पेपर प्रोग्रामिंग इन जावा. इन प्रीवियसली वी हैव डिस्कस्ड सम कॉन्सेप्ट्स ऑफ जावा. नाउ आई एम कंटिन्यूइंग प्रीवियस टॉपिक्स. सो फर्स्ट बिफोर दैट आई विल डिस्कस what are the previous topics we have studied. In the first video we have studied history of Java, that means fundamentals of Java. Here we have studied that Java is an object oriented programming language developed in Sun Microsystems. It was developed for the electronic goods. The first programming language is actually Oak, later it was named as a Java. Later you have seen the Java virtual machine JVM. It is a interpreter that can interpret the bytecode of the Java program. Next we have seen data types, primitive data types. We have explained data types are primitive and non-primitive. Primitive types are numeric and non-numeric. Numeric data types are integer, floating point. Non-numeric data types are character and boolean. We have discussed. Next, sample Java program. You have seen what is a sample Java program, how Java program looks like. So you have seen what are the elements of the Java program also. Java program ela untundi, dantlo unna statements, output statement endi, main method ela declare cheyali, class ela declare cheyali chusam. Next, creating and execution of the Java program. So ante how a Java program is created. We have studied that a Java program can be created by using a text editor such as Notepad. And Java program can be compiled from command prompt, that is a DOS command prompt. So to compile and run the Java program, we have to use the command prompt. Which keyword we have to use to compile the Java program? Java C. To run the Java program, we have to use Java keyword. To compile the Java program, Java C. To run the Java program, Java. And we also discussed why main method is public static. So generally in C and C++ language, we declare the main method as only void main. But coming to in Java, this main method must be declared as a public and static. We declare main method as a public and static. We are discussing this topic. Next, we also seen some Java programs, basic programs we discussed. Next, data conversion. How one data type can be converted into another data type we have discussed here. That is a typecasting, implicit and explicit conversion of sin. Next, conditional statements we have discussed. The conditional statements are if, simple if else, and else if ladder we have discussed. And also we have discussed the switch case. So these are the previous topics we have discussed. Now we are going into the continuation topic, that is the 11th topic, that is a looping statements. So this is the end of this chapter. If you complete the looping statements, we will complete the first chapter. So what do you mean by looping statement? First we'll see what do you mean by looping. So for example, there is a block of code is there. This block of code has to execute repeatedly. So for example, there the first statement are there, second statement there, third statement is there. So we have to execute after first, we have to execute first, second, third. After that one, again you have to execute the first one, second one, third one. Again after that, again you have to execute. So these three statements are executed repeatedly based on a condition. Based on a particular condition. If the condition is true, we have to execute these statements. If the condition is false, we have to execute, we don't execute this statement. So we have to execute these statements repeatedly as long as the condition is true. Here the condition must have a termination. The condition must terminate the loop at any point of time after a prescribed number of times. కండిషన్ డిఫైన్ చేసేటప్పుడు ఆ కండిషన్ ఏదో ఒకసారి లూప్ని టర్మినేట్ చేయాలి. ద లూప్ నెవర్ గోస్ టు ఇన్ఫైనైట్. లూప్ అనేది ఇన్ఫైనైట్గా వెళ్ళొద్దు. సో ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఇఫ్ యూ టేక్ ద నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ స్టేట్మెంట్స్, హౌ మెనీ టైమ్స్ ఇట్ విల్ ఎగ్జిక్యూట్? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, n. there must be predefined. Say we can say that n. We cannot say that it can be executed infinite. So the condition must be terminate the loop at any point of time. Now we'll see what are the looping statements. In Java, there are mainly four types of looping statements: while, do while, for, and for each statement. For each statement, these are the four types of looping statements. Four types of looping statements: while, do while, for, and for each. So generally in C, C++, we have the only three: while, do while, for, and for each loop statement. Now we'll see what is while loop statement. We'll see. So all of you know, while is a looping statement that is used to execute this a block of statements repeatedly as long as the given condition is true. There is a one test condition. This, whenever the test condition true, we had execute this statement C. Again, test is evaluated. If test is true, again we have to execute the loop. So these are the loop statement. These three blocks, these three statements are called as a looping statements, or you can say that these are the loop block. So these statements, before executing these statements, we have to check the condition. If statements so execute kadanukadu munde condition check chestundi. That means in while loop, condition is evaluated before entering into the loop. ఈ బ్లాక్ లోకి ఈ లూప్ లోకి ఎంటర్ అయ్యే ముందే కండిషన్ అనేది చెక్ చేయడం జరుగుతుంది. సో దట్స్ వై దిస్ వైల్ లూప్ ఈజ్ కాల్డ్ యాజ్ ఏ ఎంట్రీ కంట్రోల్డ్ లూప్. వైల్ లూప్ ఈజ్ కాల్డ్ యాజ్ ఏ ఎంట్రీ కంట్రోల్ లూప్. వాట్ ఇస్ ద సింటాక్స్? వాట్ ఇస్ ద సింటాక్స్ ఆఫ్ లూపింగ్ స్టేట్మెంట్? సో దెర్ ఈజ్ ఏ వైల్ కీవర్డ్ అండ్ వి హడ్ రైట్ ద కండిషన్. వైల్ కండిషన్, నెక్స్ట్ స్టేట్మెంట్స్. నెక్స్ట్ స్టేట్మెంట్స్ వి హడ్ రైట్, those statements are executed many number of times. Then later, loop counter alteration. So the loop counter means the variable that is used in the test condition. So for example, I written a I less than or equal to 10. Now I is a loop counter. I is a loop counter. So this counter variable must be altered here. Either I value must be incremented or decremented. That is alteration. So it may be incremented by 2 or decremented, whatever it may be. So that is a looping statement. So first loop is executed, first condition is executed. If condition is true, the statements in the loop are executed. After that one, again condition is evaluated. If condition is true, again the statements in the loop are executed. Again condition is evaluated. So this is called as a looping process. This is called as a looping process. So this is a while loop. So here I given a simple logic. So I taken the I is equal to 1. So 1 less than 10, yes. So I have to print the odd numbers. First I have to print the I value 1, later I is equal to 3, I equal to 5, 7, 9. So every time we are printing the same statement odd number, but value changing. So instead of value, I am taking the variable I. First time I have taken the I value 1, second time I am incrementing the I value, it becomes the 3, and again condition is testing, again I am displaying the statement. So this is a looping statement. This is the reason why we have to use the looping statement. So here this statement is executed how many times? 5 times. This statement is executed 5 times. So this is a looping statement, while loop statement. Next we will see the do while statement. So do while statement is also same as a while loop statement, but the thing is that here the loop is terminated, the condition is evaluated while exiting the loop. Condition is evaluated here, the condition is evaluated while exiting the loop. So first the statements in the loop are will be executed, and after exiting the loop we have to check the condition. This is called, this is a do while loop. So that do while is called as a exit control loop. So sir, why we have to check the condition exiting? Why don't you check the condition startingly? Starting check cheyakunda endingly eppudu check chesamo? So initially I assigned the I is equal to 1. I assigned the programmer itself assigned the value. So initially you know the value of I. So no need to check the condition. So after alteration, after changing of the I value only, I have to check whether is there any condition evaluation. So we have to check violation and any condition violation undane check cheyali. So then we have to check the condition at the exiting of the loop. So this is a do while statement. Here the while statement, do while statement, both are the looping statement that are used when more than a statement to be executed the more than number of times. So here, what is the difference? Sometimes in the examination they used to ask what is the difference between the while loop and do while. So what is the difference between while and do while? The main thing is that, so in the while is a entry controlled loop, whereas do while is a exit controlled loop. You can say that it is a exit controlled loop, or you can, while is a entry controlled loop. So next is that, so you are checking the condition before entering into the loop. So if the condition initially false, it never execute. So the minimum number of times execution of a loop statement is 0. Minimum number of times execution of the loop statement is 0. But here the loop, the condition is checking while exiting the loop, so that it will execute the minimum one time and test the condition. If test condition is false, again it will exit the loop. That means the minimum number of execution time is 1. Minimum number of times is 1. So this is the major difference between the while and do while loop. So this is a looping statement. Next we'll go for the for loop statement. So the for loop also execute the statements number of times. The for loop also executes a set of statements repeatedly. So for example, this is the first statement, second statement, third statement, fourth statement. So these statements are executed number of times, that for a specific number of times. That means there is a, you can say n, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that is a specific number of times. In for loop, the loop counter initialization, test condition, increment, decrement will be taken place at the same time, same place. So see here, in while loop or do while loop, here, so this is a initialization, this is a condition, this is a incrementing. So both are, three are done at the different places. So but in while loop, for loop statement, all initialization and condition testing and increment decrement, both, so three will be done at the single line. This is a for loop statement. In the for loop statement, groups the initialization, condition, increment, decrement in a single line. So here these are the statements to be executed. First, what happens? First, initialization will be done only one time. Initialization will be done only one time. After initialization, it goes to condition. It will test the condition. If a condition is true, the statements will be executed in the loop. After completion of the loop statement, sorry, for loop statement, it goes to the increment decrement. After increment decrement, again condition is evaluated. If the condition is true, again the statements will be executed. Again it goes to the increment decrement. Again it goes to the condition. So this process will be repeated as long as the condition is true. Whenever the condition becomes false, the loop is terminated and the statements following the loop will be executed. So this is about the for loop. So here the same program written with the for loop also. The same program written with the for loop also. Next one is that for each. So generally for each is a advanced feature of the Java looping statements. It was mainly used with the arrays. So for example, I have the 5 elements in the array. The index is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So there is an element at the 0th position, that is a 10, first position 20, second position 30, third position 40, fourth position 50. To display these values, we need to write like this, a of i. I value for I is equal to 0, I less than or is equal to for I plus plus. So we use the for loop. Instead of using this a of i, we use the for each statement. The for each statement is used to access each value in the for loop, sorry, in the array. Only to access the array elements we use the for each statement. So these are the looping statements supported in Java. These are the looping statements supported in Java. What are the looping statements? While, do while, for, and for each. So we'll see the depth of example for the for each statement in the concept of arrays. So this is a for each statement. So in the next video, I will tell you the some programs on looping statements. So after that, we'll go for the second chapter. Okay, students.